Friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So you might be aware of the fact from yesterday we started a series in which what we will be doing, we will be discussing daily 5 MCQs of any particular topic, and we will check that what is your progress. So this series will help you in we can say to get an idea about how well are you preparing for your exam. So today is video number 2. So today we will be focusing upon Indian polity. Yesterday we focused on ancient India. So let's see what are 5 questions for Indian polity that are in today's video. So the first question is, consider the following about bills referred to a joint committee of the parliament. First statement is, a joint committee cannot recommend amendment of the bill and can only record its observations on the bill. Second, a money bill cannot be referred to a joint committee of the houses. So which of the above statements are correct? So you have to choose that. You can pause the video and can mark your answer. You can think about it before proceeding to the next slide. So we are proceeding to the next slide. You have the option to pause the video. So friends, the answer is B. So statement 1 is that if a bill is referred to a select or joint committee, it considers the bill clause by clause just as the house does. So amendments can be moved to various clauses by the members of the committee. So after the report has been presented to the house of the joint committee, the member in charge of the bill usually moves the motion for the consideration of the bill as reported by the select or joint committee, as the case may be. So second is, the money bill or financial bill containing any of the provisions calculated to make a bill, a money bill, however, cannot be referred to a joint committee of the houses. So this is because Rajya Sabha has no powers of amending a money bill. So that is the reason that that a money bill cannot be referred to a joint committee of the house. So this is about your first question. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, at the commencement of first session after each general election to the house of the people, and at the commencement of the first session of each year, the president shall address both houses of parliament assembled together and inform parliament of the causes of its summons. This is a constitutional provision, B statutory provision, D C rule of procedure of the house, D parliamentary convention. So friends, you can see that how the questions are framed. So it is not just as we can say smooth ride. So UPSC sometimes asks tricky questions. So that's why we have framed tricky questions for you. So you have to choose the answer. So friends, the answer is A. That is, it is a constitutional provision. So you might be aware of the fact that in Article 87, Clause 1, it is clearly mentioned that when first session after the each general election, when the first session will be convened, then president will address the both houses of parliament, and then also at the beginning of each session of first session of the each year, this convention is followed. So this is constitutionally mandated. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, the structural part of the constitution is largely derived from A cabinet mission plan, B Lahore session of the Indian National Congress, C regulating act of 1858, D government of India act of 1935. So friends, this is a quite easy answer. I expect that you must be knowing its answer. So answer is D. That is this your Constitution of India is also referred to as Government of India 1935 Act is often referred to as blueprint of the Constitution. So that is why a large part of the Constitution has been taken from the Government of India Act 1935. So multiple provisions are there. So philosophical part, the philosophical part of the constitution, for example, fundamental rights or DPSPs are driving its inspiration from American and Irish constitutions respectively. Political part has been largely drawn from the British constitution, that is a parliamentary form of government, a cabinet government, and the relations between executive and the legislature. So all these things have been derived from British constitution. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, in the Lok Sabha, who decides the sitting order of the members? A member can sit at a place of their preference barring the first rows, B Secretary General Lok Sabha, C Leader of the House, D Speaker Lok Sabha. So this is also a quite easy answer. I expect that you must be knowing its answer. So answer is D. So these rules pertain to Lok Sabha's summon to members, seating, quorum, or affirmation and role of members. So Secretary General shall issue summons to each member specifying the date and place for a session of the House. So members shall sit in such order as the Speaker may determine. So now let's move on to the last question of the day. Last question is, in an election to a legislative assembly, all the candidates who did not win lost their deposit. How is this possible? A. The voter turnout was very low. B. Winning member must have flouted election commission's guideline. C. The election was a multi-member constituency. D. A very large number of candidates contested the election. So you have to choose that which of these is the answer. So also this is though a conceptual question, but it is a quite easy question. So you can answer it also. So answer is D. So as per Representation of People Act 1951, a general candidate for contesting an assembly election has to make a deposit of 10,000 security deposit, and it is lower for SC and ST cases and candidates, and deposit made by a candidate shall be returned if the following conditions are satisfied. If the candidate is not shown in the list of contesting candidates, that is to say either nomination was rejected or his nomination was accepted but he withdrew his candidature, and then he dies before the commencement of the poll, or he is elected, or he is not elected but more than 1/6 of the total number of valid votes polled by all the candidates at the election. If a candidate wants that his or her security deposit is not seized, he must secure 1/6 of the total number of valid votes. So if, for example, if there are large number of candidates, then if the candidate has polled exactly 1/6 of the total number of valid votes, the deposit will not be refunded. And then in any case, if he gets less than 1/6 of the total valid votes polled by the candidates, then he cannot get his deposit. So obviously, if there are large number of candidates contesting and there is lot of distribution of votes among different candidates, so there might be a possibility that each candidate gets less than 1/6 votes, and obviously a winner must be there, but that winner may be securing just less than 1/6 of the total valid votes. So in that case, security deposit will be seized. So this is all about, friends, today's discussion. So if you find that you are performing well, then that is well and good. So performing well, we can say that if your marks are ranging between 3 to 5, then you can consider that you are preparing well. So if in case your marks are less, then there is no need to worry about it. You can prepare well. So you have 6 months to prepare. Prelims is coming, but do ensure that you start preparing seriously. So if in case you are studying from home and you are finding it difficult to focus on your studies, and you are finding that you are unable to track your performance, or you are unable to complete your syllabus in a time bound manner, then we have various series for you people. So you can join those series. So one of those such series is Indian Polity NCRT series, in which we will be covering your NCRT's polity NCRT's from 6th to 12th in just rupees 149. So you will be daily given a target to read, and in the evening you will get 10 MCQs from that target. So all NCRTs from class 6 to 12 will be covered in 45 days. So in this way, you will get 10 into multiplied by 45 with 450 MCQs based upon NCRTs at the end of the 45th day. So a single magazine will also be shared with you on 45th day, which will be the compilation of all the 450 NCRT based MCQs. So if in case you are interested, then do ensure that you check the description box, because the link which is shown on your screen, it is provided in the description box. So do ensure that you check it and join our series. So this is all about, friends, today's discussion, and thank you. Have a very nice day ahead, and do ensure that you subscribe to our channels. Thank you.